If I could define a man in one word, that word would be character. Okay? Before the money, before success, before all that stuff, manhood is character. It's who you are. You know? It's something that can't be taken from you in a jail cell, even if you're stripped away of all that other stuff. It's character, it's strength, it's honoring your word, it's doing what you said you were going to do, it's being accountable. Manhood in one definition, character. Okay? Make money, but don't compromise your reputation to do it, okay? I think that's very important to learn. Don't compromise your reputation. Don't compromise your character. Because when you do, you will suffer for it. You will suffer for it. There's no shortcuts. There's no easy way. There's no free lunch. It might look like that. It might look like a shortcut. It might look like an easy way. It might look like a free lunch. But I'm telling you, by doing unethical things, that will come back around to you in one way or the other. Okay, not only is it important to protect your reputation for who you are as a man, but you're going to make more money long term with it, right? Scamming, you know, being dirty, that's a short term mentality. Okay, long term, you're thinking about legacy, you're thinking about the next 10, 20, 30 years, right? When you think long term and you're being legit, you're going to make money through referrals, right? A client that you bring on now could give you referrals for the next 30 years. Word of mouth, guys trusting you enough to do deals with you, right? More importantly, if you don't value reputation and you act like a thief and a scumbag, that's how people are going to see you forever, okay? It's not like you turn a new leaf and people are going to believe you. They're not, okay? They're not. You steal from someone once, you get caught in the public eye, you do something dirty once, that's on your record forever. As much as you try and tell people you changed. And by the way, the guy who steals once is going to steal again. I don't believe that guy is going to change. I don't believe if he's scummy, he's dirty in business, he's selling dirty products, he's scamming people. I don't believe those guys change, by the way. They'll say they change, but I don't believe they will. Okay? So don't even get started on that path or anything that's going to compromise your reputation. Even something smaller than that. Okay? Because you're always forever going to be seen fighting that off. All right. I was watching an interview a segment with Jordan Belfort, who still has a lot of money from scamming, you know, 100 million, 200 million out of people, doing whatever he can not to pay it off. By the way, they're trying to glorify that guy in movies, and he is as a career, as a personal development guy, he should be in jail forever. Okay. That's the reality of it. And, of course, these things get brought up on interviews, and he gets upset saying, I've talked about this a million times, you know, I'm over that part of my life, and people still ask him, and then he storms out of the interview, okay? He is trying to put that behind him, but other people aren't going to let that happen. Because they know a guy who scams 100 million, 200 million out of people is that kind of a person. That's your reputation, okay? That's your reputation. And you can have money and success, but what's the point when you don't have reputation? Because let's be honest, guys, money's one thing. Money buys you freedom and a quality of life. But success is how you look in other people's eyes. Let's be real. You want to be successful so other people, you know, can admire you and that you feel like you outcompeted people in the world and you feel good about yourself and your family can look up to you and your friends can look up to you and, you know, you beat the people you went to high school with. Okay, if you're being honest, a lot of success, I mean, success is in competition with, or in opposition with people who aren't successful. It's defined by how other people see it, by how you do in the world, and it's defined in other people's eyes. So what's the point of being successful, okay, when people think you're a scumbag? So you work hard for all the success, for this reputation, but you don't get that reputation because you burned it all by being a scumbag. You might get the money, okay? You might get the money, but then you're always worried about, is the government gonna come take this from me? Am I gonna get sued? When's the next shoe gonna drop? Am I gonna get caught for this? Or is someone gonna call me out today? Or is someone gonna call me out on the street? You know, call me a scumbag because I sold them some garbage, right? Is that client that I fucked over, are they gonna find where I live and try and come get their money back? On and on and on and on, okay? You sell scam products, if you sell scam services, if you're dirty, in business, that's gonna haunt you forever. If you're dirty with your friends or people you know, they're gonna talk about you forever like that, dude. And forever you're gonna be having to have psychic tension and fight, trying not to get caught. When you're legit, you can sleep well. It's like, what can people say about you? They can't. You know they can't say anything. They know you. They might say, "Well, I don't like him," or "He's kind of a dick," but they can't say he broke his word. They can't say he's unethical. They can't say he sells garbage products. They can't say he sells garbage services. They can't say he screwed me over, right? And that's what matters in business, right? Okay. When you don't break your word and you don't snake people, what can people say about you outside of, like, "I don't like him," or, you know, that's it, really.